سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وارزقنا علما وعملا صالحا متقبلا يا رب العالمين. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه ولا تجعلهما متشابهين علينا فنضل ونتبع الهوى برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful. Peace and prayers on Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him and his family and companion till the day of judgment. Today, inshallah, we will continue talking and interpreting and talking about lights regarding Surah Al-Mulk. Alhamdulillah that Allah has honored us talking about his book, talking about his words. Alhamdulillah that Allah has made us reflect and talk and interpret and think about his signs, about his words, about his glory. Alhamdulillah that Allah has blessed us with talking and interpreting about his book. When we are talking about Surah Al-Mulk, we started last week talking a little bit regarding the most important themes in Surah Al-Mulk. And we talk that Surah Al-Mulk is one of the Meccan surah which was revealed in the early times of Mecca, which was revealed to Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, to talk about the glory of Allah to Quraysh, who were the disbeliever, who disbelieve in Allah and who disbelieve in the Messenger of Allah, and they were continuous in their disbelief, and they were continuous in their aggressing Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, and the message of Allah. For that, this verse was a revelation from Allah as a warning for them to fear Allah and to know who is that Lord who they don't believe or they don't want to believe about him, or they don't want to believe in him. So that verse, Surah Al-Mulk, as we said, is talking about the glory of Allah, the dominion of Allah, and the dominions of Allah, talking about how great is Allah, and Allah has started talking in it, regarding himself, glorifying himself, praising himself, and describing himself, subhanAllah. When Allah has started by Tabarak alladhi biyadihi al-mulk, subhanAllah, you find that it's a very powerful, very strong verse, starting with a word which is strong word, Tabaraka. Tabaraka, which means he is very blessed, that creator, that Lord, that Ilah who has created the whole universe, who has created everything and who has the dominion over everything and who has the dominion over all of his creation, even you creatures, even you human beings, even you believers or non-believers. Subhanallah. So you find that this verse is a very strong verse. It's a warning to the disbelievers, talking about the punishment in hellfire, talking about that warning from Allah regarding the disbelief in Allah and disbelief of the message of Allah and the messenger of Allah. We said that there are many lessons in the verses of the Holy Quran, and each verse has its subject and it has its topic and has its lessons, which are certain lessons from each one. And from Surah Al-Mulk, there are certain lessons which will be derived from it. You find that it's a warning to the Quraysh, the disbeliever, who don't want to believe in Allah and this deen and the monotheism of Allah, the tawheed of Allah, and they don't want to follow it. They don't want to believe in everything regarding this worldly life and regarding the hereafter. We find that this verse is a very great challenge to human beings. Challenge to think, challenge to reflect, challenge to know who is your Lord. Think about your Lord, think about the universe around you, think about yourselves. Even regarding the disbelievers, you find that the Quraysh Quraishi disbelievers, they were they didn't even want to think about the universe around them. So they were telling Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, and handing some dust from the earth and saying to him, mocking his message and mocking his deen, telling him, will or is your Lord capable or able to bring us again, but after we became like this dust in the earth? Subhanallah, Allah is telling them, look around you. Not look around you, around the earth, around you. Look around the heaven. Look around the sky. Look around the stars. Look around the seven heavens who are above you. And there are more than them. وَيَخْلُقُ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. When Allah has said seven heavens, which are tibaqa, as we will see now. So Allah is talking about these seven heavens, but there are other creations. There are other things that we don't know anything regarding them. Subhanallah. For that, you find that the true believer and the believer who wants, who is using, and who has that pure heart and pure mind, those people, those true people, or those true believers, alladina, there is a very important description for them and very important attribute in them, which is very valuable, which is alladina yu'minuna bil ghaib. Yu'minuna bil ghaib, which means they believe in the unseen. They believe in Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, and they believe in Allah. And they believe in everything Allah has said in his Holy Quran, and Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, has said it. So they believe in the unseen, because we will know that there are things that we can't see them and we can't touch them. So we can't figure them or comprehend them in our five senses. There are things which are beyond our five senses, like day of judgment, like the grave, like the afterlife, like the hereafter, like the jinn, like angels, a lot of things. Which for that, when Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said that the pillars of Iman, we know that the pillars of Islam, and tashhad an la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammad Rasulullah, and to zakat, to qima salat, which are to perform your prayer, and to fast your month, Ramadan, then you perform pilgrimage, and you do your zakah. This is regarding Islam, the pillars of Islam. But when you want to go a further step, when you want to go a higher step to be a believer, believer is a high stage. It is a high level. So this believer, pillars of belief, or pillars of faith, or pillars of Iman, أن تؤمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله واليوم الآخر والقدر خيره وشره, is to believe in Allah and to believe in his angels and to believe in his prophets and messengers, his messengers and prophets, and to believe in the day after, and to believe in the destiny, خيره وشره, which is good and which is bad. So all these are regarding the unseen, believing in the unseen. For that, when Allah has started his Surah Al-Baqarah, subhanAllah, in the very, very first page in Surah Al-Baqarah, when Allah said, Alif Lam Mim, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ, there is no doubt about it, الَّذِينَ هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ, which is a guidance. Guidance for those. It's a guidance for the pious people. It's a guidance for the righteous people. Those righteous people, what is the description of them? What about their attributes? الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ. This is the first attribute regarding your Iman. If you want to be a good believer, if you want to be a truthful believer of Allah, not only Muslim, there are a lot of Muslims in all over the world. But you will find that there are many Muslims who are Muslims in their identity card only. Only they are Muslims in their names or maybe in their shape, in their form. But if you come to their iman, if you come to their actions, if you come to their belief in Allah, you'll find that their iman is very shallow and very weak. But subhanAllah, the believer is different. Believer is a high, high level and high rank. And you have to be a believer. And there are some, and there are different verses and ayat, which are Allah is addressing all people in general. Allah is saying, Ya ayyuhan nas. Ya ayyuhan nas, which means all people, Muslims and non-Muslims, believers and non-believers, all the human beings. Ya ayyuhan nas. In another verses, Allah is saying, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu. Here Allah is addressing those elite people. Allah is addressing those people whom His light and His nur has entered their hearts, whom their that light and nur of Allah has entered their actions, whom that light of Allah has entered their life. You'll find that their actions, their words, their love, their fear of Allah, and their love of Allah is the love and actions of the believer. And you'll know that from their actions, from their life, which will be very clear from their, subhanAllah, attitude regarding as-sirat al-mustaqim. So here we will know that when you are a believer, so you, the first attribute that you should have, that you should be from those people, الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ. For that, here Allah in Surah Al-Mulk, Allah is talking, at first, in the beginning of the surah, Allah is glorifying Himself. Allah is praising Himself, تَبَارَكَ الَّذِي بِيَدِهِ الْمُلْكِ. Then after that, Allah is talking regarding this life. Allah is addressing the disbelievers, warning disbelievers, look at this life, look at the purpose of this life, look at, you have to know who is your Lord and why are you here in this life. Then after that, Allah said, Tabarak alladhi biyadihi al-mulk, Allah is talking about His dominion. Then, وَهُوَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ. Allahu عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ. Allah is the capable of everything He wants. So Allah, لا يعجزه شيء, which means nothing that Allah can do it. Nothing is impossible to Allah. Nothing is difficult to Allah. Nothing is hard to Allah. Because Allah is different. Here Allah is setting a thing that you have to know who are you and who is your Lord. There is, Allah is telling them to think, to reflect, to know. You have to know that you are very different. Your Lord is very different from you. You have to know who is your Lord. الَّذِي بِيَدِهِ الْمُلْكِ. And what about, what after it? وَهُوَ, Allah is talking about Himself. عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ. كُلِّ شَيْءٍ. Everything is under His dominance. Everything is under His control. Everything is under His will. Everything is under His irada and mashi'ah. Subhanallah, this is the will of Allah. For that, Allah said in Surah Al-Kahf, وَلَا تَقُولَنَّ لِشَيْءٍ إِنِّي فَاعِلٌ ذَلِكَ غَدًا إِلَّا أَنْ يَشَاءَ اللَّهِ. This is a lesson to all the believers. Don't say about anything that I will do that without saying inshallah. Inshallah, the real inshallah, which means I will do that inshallah, which means I can't do anything except by the will of Allah. So I will do my best and I will do what I have to do. And this is my will, this is my intention, this is my capability and qudra. This is what I can do, but it is related and it's restricted by the will of Allah. If Allah has accepted and if Allah wanted it to happen, so it will happen. And if Allah it doesn't want it to happen and it's not in the mashi'ah of Allah, the irada of Allah, the will of Allah, so it will not happen. This is the full submission of Allah. That that iman, that feeling should be in the heart of every Muslim and every mu'min, every believer. To know that he can't do anything except by the will of Allah. For that Allah said, Allah is reminding in each word, in each word. Each word has a purpose, each word has meaning in it. وَهُوَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى وَهُوَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. Then Allah is talking about himself, about his qudra, his capability. الَّذِي خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةِ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا وَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الْغَفُورُ. Subhanallah ta'ala, alladhi khalaqa, Allah is talking about himself, khalaqa, who is the only creator who can create. Here Allah is making an exception and a complete and full exception. Alladhi khalaqa, which means there is no other creator who can create like him. There are a lot of so-called creators, but they are not creators. Allah creates from nothingness to existence, not like the others who are making, who are renewing, who are doing, who are making. This is sunnah. But Allah is khalq, al-khalq, which means to make something from nothing, from nothingness to existence, from stillness to existence. This is khalq. هذا خلق الله فأروني ماذا خلق الذين من دونه. سبحان الله تعالى. Allah is talking about himself سبحان الله in pride. Allah is proud about himself and Allah is knowing himself. Who is he? As he is the creator who has created all that, who has created us and who has created you. And Allah is addressing this believer, I have created you and I know what do you think and I know how do you think, subhanAllah. So here Allah is saying, الَّذِي خَلَقَ خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا.
أستاذ لما
شبكة ضعيفة عندها
أستاذ لما بس الشبكة ظاهر شوي قطع الإرسال قطع البث افتح الكاميرا أستاذة افتح الكاميرا أستاذة لما أيوة أستاذة نما ما في صوت.
We find that we are affected by this. By life. So we find that death is more impressive to us, control, something which is unclear to us. We don't know anything regarding death of our life, private regarding our life. Life made death something unknown to us, to feel its subhanAllah, to have its value and to feel how important is death and to feel how powerful is Allah. And to feel and to know how is important to have that relation with Allah, as He has made the knowledge regarding death is not unknown to anyone except by Allah. No one on this earth knows what time he will die. No one knows when he will die. No one knows how will he die. However, how much knowledgeable he is, how even regardless what kind of science he has, even if he's scientist, even if he's doctor, even he is whatever, but when he comes to the question of death, he doesn't know about it. Even if some doctors or scientists or whatever, if they decide that this person will die maybe within 72 hours, 24 hours, or whatever, or maybe after 3 hours, we'll find that it's not accurate and not clear, and it will not happen as they say, subhanAllah. And they don't know regarding their death, if they know regarding him, and even it's not accurate at all, and they don't know any details regarding how and what time exactly or whatever, subhanAllah. What about their death? They don't know about their death, their life, how, where, what kind, and what about their age? How old are they? Is it close or is it far away? Will they die now or after time? And even when we have now like some diseases that they are now like coronavirus now, you find that this was dangerous, and it was like a nightmare for people, subhanAllah. Why? To know the greatness of Allah, to know that you are leading with the Lord, who is the creator and who is the dominion for over all this earth. So when Allah has created death and life, death and life are contrary to each other. Allah is telling you, I have created death and I have created life. I am the one and the only one who have given you life, and I am the only one who can take that life. I am the only one who can give you hope, and I am the only one who can take that hope from you. I am the only one who can save you, and I'm the only one who can damage you and hurt you. You find that from this, that the iman should be strong regarding this Lord. When I know that no one can take my life except him. So how strong are those people? They can't do any harm to me except by the will of my Lord. When he stay and when he agree and when there is according to his will, so it will happen. So anything will happen to me is according to the will of Allah, not the will of human being. Even if they think that it's according to their will. But in reality, the reality is the most important to me, which is in reality, it's according to Allah, not according to them. So my life is in the hands of Allah. My rizq is in the hands of Allah. My health is in the hands of Allah. My children is in the hands of Allah. My home is in the hands of Allah. Everything regarding me is in the hands of Allah. Everything in me is in the hands of Allah. And my life, my death, قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي, as when Sayyidina Ibrahim said, قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ بِذَلِكَ أُمِرْتُ وَأَنَا مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي, my prayer, my life, وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي, my life and my death is for Allah. صلاتي ونسكي ومحياي ومماتي. For who, ya Allah? It's for you, Allah. لله رب العالمين. بذلك أمرت. I have ordered and I was commanded of that from my Lord. He has commanded me to give my life to him, to give my death to him, to give my body to him, to give my money to him, to give my mind to him, to give everything in me to him, and he will give me everything in there, subhanAllah. In this life and in the hereafter, I will find that in this life and in the hereafter. You find that, subhanAllah, every good you are doing with Allah, you will find its reward in this life before, and you'll find then double and double and double of that reward in the hereafter. But Allah will give your reward in this life before, to let you live the beauty of the obedience of Allah, live the beauty of that beautiful relation of Allah with Allah, live that tranquility, sakina, tumanina, that will come to your heart from that beautiful relation with Allah. This is alladhina, as we said, alladhi khalaqa al-mawta wal-hayata, subhanallah. الذي خلق الموت والحياة, Allah has created your life, all of your lives, you and the people who are before you and the people who are after you till the day of judgment. From Sayyidina Adam عليه السلام till the day of judgment, subhanAllah, the life of all those people, human beings, is for a certain purpose. This is for certain actions. All that lives is according to what Allah has commanded them to be, subhanAllah. خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوكم. Here the most important word, ليبلوكم, يبلوكم, to test you, which means this life is a trial. This life is a trial to all people. This life is a test, to test your iman, to test your faith, to test your patience, to test your love, to test your capability, to test your qudra, and to test your patience and your will to be a good believer in the eye of Allah. To test your actions, are they in the way of Allah? Are they suitable to the words of Allah? Do you follow the orders of Allah in your life? So this is a trial, and this is the most important thing that we have to know, that Allah has made us on this earth for a certain purpose, which is وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنْسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I have never created except for worship, to worship me. So Allah has created us on this earth to worship him, to follow him, to obey him, and to do according to what he has told us to do, according to his straight path, as-sirat al-mustaqim. Not to follow our worldly desire, not to follow our nafs, not to follow waswasat al-shaytan, not to follow the bad people, not to follow our inner desires, not to follow anything which will attach us to that life, or to this life, which can make us be far away, to let us be attached to this life in something that can make us feel that we want this life and we don't think about the hereafter. Which means to let us think about our priority in this life. What is our priority? Our priority is Allah, Allah, and to obey Allah, and to be from the beloved of Allah. This is when I have that, so I will understand and I will think regarding the words in the Holy Quran. When Allah said, الَّذِي خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ test you أيكم أحسن عملا. Who in his action? Allah didn't say أيكم أحسن قولا. Allah was emphasizing the importance of words. Many easy, but actions are hard. These are hard to the things that we like in our hearts. Subhanallah. ليبلوكم أيكم
عمل. أستاذ الكاميرا مسكرة.
الكاميرا؟
أيوة.
الكاميرا من عندي مفتوحة حبيبتي. طيب يلا فتحت. ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا. Who is the best in his repentance of Allah, who is the best in his watch, is thinking, is this good in the eye of Allah or not? Is this halal? I can do that. Who is أيكم أحسن وعمل in this life, in the other people, with himself and with others, that, subhanAllah, they have the most important value in the eye of Allah, the actions. We know that Allah will account us according to our intentions and to our actions. So when we want to do something, we have to know that this will please Allah. If it doesn't please, so I am in the trial, that I am in a test. What shall I do? What will I do? We know here that أيكم أحسن عملا, which one of you, we have to think regarding or within ourselves, and to think outside ourselves. There is a better person within me. There is a better person like me, my name, myself, who is within me, which is better than me. I can bring him out. I can let that person be in my life, which is that if I take care of my thoughts, my action, of my intention, of my words, of my things, of everything regarding, is it in the cause of Allah? Is it pleasing or Allah, or is it or it doesn't please Allah? So there is a better person who could be if I take care about it better and better and better. So I work a little bit harder in my fear of Allah, a little bit harder of my piety, to be righteous, to know what about my piety. Am I biased or not? Or what is the level of my piety? SubhanAllah, at-taqwa. To think in myself, أيكم أحسن عملا, to think within myself, If I'm steady, if I'm steady myself upon الصراط المستقيم, am I steady myself upon الصراط المستقيم? Am I following Allah and following Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him? Or am I following my desires? Am I following my things that I like? Regardless if they according to Allah or not, subhanallah. So what about my asrat al-mustaqim, subhanallah? Ayyukum ahsanu amala. So am I remain firm in my istiqama? What about my istiqama? What about my fear of Allah? What about my relation with Allah? So here Allah is setting a basis regarding your relation with him. So Allah is talking about himself, glorifying himself. He is the Lord, he is the King, he is the dominion. So then Allah is telling, بِيَدِهِ الْمُلْكِ. Then Allah خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. To test you. So this life, the reality of this life is a test. This life is not for entertainment, not to entertain yourself all the time, not to have fun all the time. It's a time of hard working. It's a time of work hard to gain the pleasure of Allah. It's a time that it's a time of work
أي أستاذة تفتح بس الفيديو أستاذة لأنه تسكر.
يلا فتحت.
بس الشبكة ظاهر اليوم معك مشكلة في الشبكة أستاذة لأنه يطلعك ويدخلك كم مرة.
ما بعرف غريب سبحان الله ليش هيك عامل انت. As we said that سبحان الله he said لا تزول قدم عبد يوم القيامة حتى يسأل عن أربع. In his heart that he is saved from hellfire until he is asked about four things, four major things in all of his life regarding his life in this worldly life. حتى يسأل عن أربع عن عمره فيما أفناه, about his life, what about his life, how was his life. الله خلق الموت والحياة. الله yeah, end your life. عن عمره فيما أفناه وعن شبابه فيما أبلاه and about his this time of his youth, when he has that ability to worship and to do and to the community. So what in all of his life regarding this strong time, his youth, subhanAllah, when he was young. Then وعن شبابه فيما أبلاه عن عمره فيما أثناه وعن شبابه فيما أبلاه وعن ماله من أين كسبه وفيما أنفقه. And he will be asked about his money, where did he get that money from, and how and where did he spend that money? Is that haram or halal? Was the source of that money halal or haram? And what about the kind of his spending that money? Is he spending it in a halal or haram? Subhanallah. عن شبابه فيما أبلاه وعن ماله من أين أنفقه وفيما من أين اكتسبه وفيما أنفقه سبحان الله العظيم. So this life is a trial, a test to you, and it's a test
أستاذ لما. وصلت الشبكة، بس إذا ممكن تفتحي الفيديو مرة ثانية. أيوه
حبيبتي، أنا فتحت الكاميرا. سبحان الله. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. So we know that here when we are talking about this trial in life, to know about this opportunity in this life. So Allah is warning the believers, and Allah is giving a warning to the believers and to all human beings to know that this life is a trial. This is the reality to test your actions. Even if this life has taken you in some sins, and even if you have, subhanAllah, made many mistakes in your life, but the door of repentance is open to you, and Allah has opened all the doors of His rahmah to His believers and to His creation and to His creation who has, Allah has created them with His love and His mercy. So when you go back to Allah and you repent truthfully from your heart, from within your heart, asking Allah to forgive your sins, you will find that you can. Allah will accept, and Allah will accept your repentance if you are truthful and honest in it. Allah will accept it. Why? Because this life is a trial. This is not final. This life is not final. Don't let this life cheat you and think that you will live eternal life in it. No, it's only a test. And you have to know in each time, every morning, every day, in everything, that this is a test. The test will be in many, many shapes and many types, subhanAllah, according to each person and to each human being. If someone is wealthy and has money, Allah will test him regarding his money. If someone has knowledge, Allah will test him regarding his knowledge. If someone is anything, all the blessings of Allah and all the bounties of Allah, Allah will test you in them. To know what about them? Will you fear Allah in them? Will you follow Allah in them? Will you follow the words of Allah and the orders of Allah? So when you say, "Oh Allah, I want you," which means, "Oh Allah, I want you," which means I will obey you. Not only I want you, this is words, but actions are the signs of your obedience and your true need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For that, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said, Al-Imanu ma waqara fil qalb wa saddaqahu al-amal. Al-Iman, faith, is that pure feeling that you feel it in your heart. Waqara fil qalb, which means its center is in your heart. But wa saddaqahu, and the actions were the subhanallah, confirmation about them. But the actions are the things that affirm and emphasize that, yes, oh Allah, I want you, I need you, and my actions are a sign of my trustfulness. So for that, it's a trial. لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا وَهُوَ, then Allah is talking about himself, وَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ Allah is describing himself, وَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الْعَزِيزُ, which means here, after Allah saying, said that this life is a trial, is a test, then Allah is coming back to talk about himself, his attributes, Al-Aziz, which means Allah doesn't mean you. Allah doesn't need you. Allah doesn't need your worship. Allah Al-Ghani, wa huwa Al-Aziz. Al-Aziz, which means he has Al-Izz, he has the glory. So Allah, Allah doesn't need the worship of his creatures. Creatures, his creatures are in very big need to the help of Allah, to the rida of Allah, to the pleasure of Allah, as he is the one who has given them their life, and he is the one who has his life and his and their life and their deaths are in his hands. For that, we need him and he doesn't need us. وَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ العزيز, which means he has العز, he doesn't need, and الغفور, who is, as we said before, when Allah is matching two of his attributes with each other, subhanAllah, you find that the first one is talking about Allah in his attributes, and the second one is talking about the attributes of Allah in his relation and in his connection with his creatures. So the first one, Al-Aziz, talking about Allah. His names, one of his great names, Al-Aziz, subhanAllah. Then Allah is talking about the other attributes of him, which is matching with it, Al-Ghafoor. Al-Ghafoor is an exaggeration name of Allah from Al-Maghfirah. Al-Maghfirah, he is the all-forgiving. All forgiving. Allah didn't describe himself that he is ghafir. There is another verse which is ghafir dhambi. But here Allah is saying al-ghafur. This is an exaggeration regarding al-ghafur, al-maghfira, which means he has maghfira. He's the Lord who is dealing with his creatures with mercy, with maghfira, with rahmah, with love. So whatever you have done, this life is trial. Whatever you have done, don't have despair of my rahmah. Don't have despair of my mercy. Don't have despair of my forgiving. I will forgive you if you come back honest to me. Don't care about your sins. I can't forgive them. And I want to forgive them if you are sincere in your repentance, if you are sincere in your coming back, if you are sincere in your heart. If you are sincere in your feelings, subhanAllah. As we said, when Allah has made us in this life to worship Him, Allah doesn't need our worship. This worship is us, and its benefits are to us, not to Allah. Allah doesn't care about our worship. Allah, there is nothing good that will come to Allah out of our worship. Our worship will not benefit or nor harm Allah. Allah is in a complete ghina. Allah in a complete izz from our worship. Either we worship Him or we didn't worship Him. This worship has a great benefit to us. We are the one who will benefit from this worship. For that, Allah said, وَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ The first talking about Himself, and the second is talking about His relation with his creation. SubhanAllah al-Azim. Then Allah is telling in Surah Al-Mulk, وَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الْغَفُورُ الَّذِي This pronoun here, الَّذِي is coming back to Allah. الَّذِي خَلَقَ The first one, الَّذِي خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا This is the first one. Now the second one, الَّذِي خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ الَّذِي خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا This is the first one. Then, الَّذِي خَلَقَ سَبْعَ سَمَاوَاتٍ طِبَاقًا ما ترى في خلق الرحمن التفاوت فارجع البصر هل ترى من فطور سبحان الله here Allah is talking about his creation الذي خلق Allah is addressing this universe الذي خلق سبع سماوات طباقا طباقا what the meaning of طباقا طباقا means which are levels over each other levels over each other سبع سماوات, seven heavens, which are layers and levels over each other. What about these heavens? سبع سماوات انطباقا. Allah is telling the disbelievers and the believers and all of these human beings, look around you, look at the heavens, look at the stars, look at the planets, look at the great creatures. Everything I have created is great, subhanAllah. And all that great creatures indicate the greatness of the creator who has created them. So if the people are not able or unable to count the stars in the heaven, can they be able or are they able to figure or to try to imagine who is Allah, or to know things regarding Allah, the creator who has placed these stars in the sky, subhanAllah. So if they are unable to get to know the creatures, so what about the creator? Can they know the creator? The creator, can they get to know the creator who has created them? Of course, subhanAllah. Well, for that, Allah said, subhanAllah, Allah has said, الَّذِي خَلَقَ سَبْعَ سَمَاوَاتٍ طِبَاقًا مَا تَرَى فِي خَلْقِ الرَّحْمَنِ مِنْ تَفَاوُتٍ مَا تَرَى, you will not see. Look at the skies, look at the heavens, look at the stars, look at them to see who is your Lord. And then you will know that, subhanAllah al-Azim, ma tara fi khalq ar-Rahman min tafawut. Allah has given him the result. Allah has given him the end. Lan tara, which means you will not see. Ma tara, ma ra'ayta, you haven't seen and you will not see. This is the meaning of ma tara, which means in the past, you can't see something in the past and you can't see something in the present and you will not see something in the future. This is something which is a reality regarding the creation of Allah. Neither in the past, nor in the present, nor in the future. Matter you will never see. في خلق الرحمن من تفاوت. You will not find, you are not able, and you can't, because there is no. You can't find it because it's unexisted. That you will find something which is imperfect. You will not find imperfect, any imperfect things in the creation of Allah. ما ترى في خلق الرحمن ما ترى في خلق الرحمن من تفاوت. You will not find in the creation of Allah, you will not find in the heavens, you will not find even a single flaw. You will not find even a single flaw in the skies, nor a rift in it, subhanAllah. You will not find any imperfection in it. This is regarding the perfection of the creation of Allah. This is one of the most important themes in the whole surahs. Allah is assuring them and emphasizing them in the verses and in the ayat. So when Allah is talking about His creation, when Allah was talking about this perfection of His creation, Allah has said, ما ترى في خلق الرحمن من تفاوت. You will not find any imperfection in his creation. Why Allah has mentioned his name here, في خلق الرحمن? Why didn't he mention في خلق العزيز? Why he didn't mention ما ترى في خلق الله من تفاوت? Why didn't he mention any of his names, his beautiful names? Why didn't he say ما ترى في خلق الكريم من تفاوت? He didn't say ما ترى في خلق العظيم من تفاوت. He said ما ترى في خلق الرحمن من تفاوت. This is a message. This is a message to know that Allah has created all His creation by His rahmah. Allah has created all His creation from His rahmah. And when Allah has created you as a human being on this earth, Allah has created you by His rahmah, and Allah wanted you to deal with His creation with rahmah. Allah is assuring and emphasizing His name here, ما ترى في خلق الرحمن من تفاوت. To know that in all of the creation of Allah, you are dealing with ar-Rahman. In all of His creation, in everything He has created, animals, birds, seas, mountains, human beings, even in your body, subhanAllah, even when you reflect regarding your body, regarding your health, regarding your organs, regarding the systems in your body, you find that everything is dealing, and everything is dealing with the rahmah of Allah. Allah is dealing with us by His mercy. This is the name that Allah loves it. For that Allah is saying, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. SubhanAllah, this is the only attribute of Allah that Allah has mentioned it twice in two names. So in each thing that you want to do, you have to say, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Bismillah, Bismillah, Bismillah. You don't say Bismillah al-Azim. You don't say Bismillah al-Kareem. We can say it if we like. But subhanAllah, the thing that Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, told us about it, that Prophet Muhammad said, كُلُّ شَيْءٍ لَا يَبْدَأُ بِبِسْمِ اللَّهِ فَهُوَ أَبْتَرْ. Anything that you don't start it with the name of Allah, so it's incomplete, it's abtar, incomplete, which means adim al-nafa' or in a less benefit, subhanAllah al-azim. So when Allah in each part, in each juz, in each verse of the Holy Quran, you have to start it with Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. And even the scholars, they differed regarding, is it Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim? Is it a verse? It's an ayah from the verses, or is it separated ayah from it. So some of them said that it is from the verses, and some of them said that no, it is a separate ayah which should be recited in each verse before recited it. So to indicate and to emphasize Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim. So Allah has created this earth and the heavens and everything in the heavens, the souls, spirits, the jinn, everything on this earth. Allah, everything on this earth, Allah has created by His mercy. To know the value of mercy and to be merciful with yourself, to be merciful with other people, to be merciful with your wife, with your husband, to be merciful with your children, to be merciful in your dealing with others, to be merciful in your work, whatever is your work is, to be merciful with animals, to be merciful in all of your life. Why? Because Allah the merciful, Allah the Almighty, Allah the All Merciful is dealing with you with His mercy, and Allah is teaching you the importance of mercy. So in your life, if you want to be a good believer, mercy should be one of your most important attributes. And you have to train yourself, train your heart, train your mind about mercy. If you find that, some people, they have, subhanAllah, hard hearts, subhanAllah. Some people have soft hearts. Some people have hard hearts. If you find that your heart, قاسي القلب, some people do something wrong or do sins or mistakes or whatever, subhanAllah. So that كلا بل ران على قلوبهم ما كانوا يكسبون. It will be a ran. It will ran, which means a cover. It's a black cover out of sins, out of mistakes, out of ma'asi, subhanAllah. So it will make a cover on the heart, that the heart will be solid, the heart will be hard. The heart will not be that soft, clean, pure heart that love Allah and seek the pleasure of Allah. So when they hear the words of Allah, when they hear something regarding Allah and the deen or whatever, they will not, these words will not touch their hearts. Why? Because there are some blocks on the hearts. This is ran, subhanAllah. So to remove that ran from your heart. So Allah, when you remove that ran from the heart, you feel that your heart, remove it by forgiveness, by repentance. For that, Allah is saying, وَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ وَالْغَفُورُ الْغَفُورُ. Even if you do sins, even if you have that ran, even if you, when you come back to Allah, when you remove that ran, when you forgive, when you ask forgiveness from Allah, when you ask repentance from Allah, Allah will accept you. Because Allah wants you to worship Him. Allah doesn't want to punish you. Allah wants you to be from the best people. Allah doesn't want to punish people. Subhanallah al-Azim. الذي خلق سبع سماوات طباقا ما ترى في خلق الرحمن من تفاوت. Whatever and however and how much you look at the skies, you will not find any imperfect thing in it. You will not find any, subhanAllah, any rift in it. You will not find any mistake in it. Why? Because Allah, the all perfect, is the all complete, is the one who has created, is the one who has created it. You will be amazed when you are looking at the skies, when you are looking at the heavens, when you are looking at the mountains, seas, when you are looking and reflecting regarding your body, you will be amazed regarding the perfect creation of Allah subhanallah al-azim. That will give you strong feeling and strong, and that will strengthen your iman, your iman with Allah. You, when you know that Allah has created you, Allah has blessed you, and Allah has given you that opportunity to live this life and to go back to Him, to repent to Him, and to be a good believer, and to be a good person in this life, who is doing the things that Allah has ordered him to do them. الذي خلق سبع سماوات طبقا ما ترى في خلق الرحمن من تفاوت فرجع البصر هل ترى من فطور فرجع البصر. Then Allah is ordering us to think, to reflect. سبحان الله فرجع البصر هل ترى من فطور خلق سبع سماوات طبقا ما ترى في خلق الرحمن من تفاوت فرجع البصر هل ترى من فطور فرجع البصر, which means look again and look again and look again, over and over and over, not only one time, one and twice and third, and reflect, who can create things like this? Can this life, can this nature create itself by itself like this? Subhanallah, subhanallah, of course not. Can any human being create this universe? Can he create this heavens? Can he create these seven heavens? Subhanallah. Look about them. Look about all the creation. Allah. Who is the one who has created them? Allah. سبع سماوات طباقا. ما ترى في خلق الرحمن من تفاوت. فرجع البصر هل ترى من فطور. So let your sight come back again to you. What about the news? What are the things that it will come and tell you? Nothing. There is no imperfect thing in this life. If there is any little or slight thing which is wrong regarding the creation of the universe, you will find a lot of things or disasters that will happen. But the system of this life is walking and going naturally, subhanAllah, by the will of Allah, as Allah, the Creator, has created it. And Allah has ordered it, subhanAllah al-Azim. And even the heavens, even the mountains, even the seas, all of them are worshipping Allah. وَإِن مِّن شَيْءٍ إِلَّا يُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِهِ وَلَكَنْ لَا تَفْقَهُونَ. Everything Allah has created is worshipping Allah, is making tasbih to Allah. Yusabbihu bihamdihi, which means saying subhanallah wa bihamdihi in their nature, not in our nature. We can't say that the sea is making tasbih to Allah like us. He's saying subhanallah, like our sounds, like our words, like our voices. They are not a human being, but they are making the speech to Allah according to their nature. Like the birds, they are making the speech to Allah according to their natures, in their sounds, subhanAllah, in their beautiful sounds. They are saying subhanAllah wa alhamdulillah. They are making the speech to Allah. Well, then, like subhanAllah, Allah said, وَيُسَبِّحُ الرَّعْدُ بِحَمْدِهِ وَيُسَبِّحُ الرَّعْدُ بِحَمْدِهِ وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ بِحَمْدِهِ. Even the angels are making tasbih. Not even, the angels are making tasbih. They are making tasbih to Allah all the time. لَا يَفْتُرُونَ, they don't stop. Why? Because Allah has created them in certain purposes, in certain goals, in certain actions, only to do so and so and so, subhanAllah. And Allah has created us in another certain actions, subhanAllah. So they don't think, they only obey Allah, only obeying Allah, the angels. So the angels are making tasbih Allah all the time. Subhanallah. And all the creatures are making tasbih Allah. The sound of the sea is making tasbih. Subhanallah, the sound of the birds are making tasbih. All the animals that are making tasbih. Every creature Allah has created it. Allah has made him in fitra and making tasbih to him according to his nature, not like us. They are not a human being. But they are worshipping Allah. They are worshipping Allah. هل ما ترى في خلق الرحمن من تفاوت فرجع البصر هل ترى من فطور. When your sight came back to you, what about the news that it will bring to you? They will bring the news of the perfection of the creation of Allah. That Allah is the only creator. Allah al-Khaliq, Allah al-Qawi, Allah the only one who is worth to be worshipped. Allah al-Malik, Allah al-Qadir, who is able to do everything he wants, and who has created this life, and who has created the hereafter, who has created life, who has created death, who has created this worldly life, and who has created the hereafter, who has created the day of judgment, who has created jinn, who has created angels, who has created you, and created وَيَخْلُقُ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. And Allah has created many, many, many and a lot of things that you don't know. You don't know anything regarding. Subhanallah al-Azim. Today we spoke about some of the important themes regarding Surah Al-Mulk. Subhanallah. Surah Al-Mulk. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. We thank Allah that Allah has blessed us by talking about Him and talking about His words, talking about His book, and talking about this verse. Alhamdulillah, thank you for joining us and thank you for your participation with us. And I hope that inshallah in the next session, inshallah, we will talk about another themes and ideas regarding this verse, inshallah. Thank you for listening. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Jazakallah.